is Kristine Nichols. I'm with the Rodale Institute, and I'm here with the Center for Food Safety on presenting about soils as a solution to climate change.
So tell us about the 4P1000 that we've been hearing so much about. What is the initiative, and why is it so groundbreaking?
Well, the initiative is so groundbreaking, I think, because it is really looking at trying to come up with a viable solution to climate change, and really looking at agriculture and agroecology and the soil as a big potential for that. So the whole idea is what they want to do is they want to increase the amount of carbon in the soil every year by 0.4%, which sounds like a very small number, but it's very significant over time. I mean, in 10 years, you're looking at, increasing carbon very significantly in soil. So it's something that can be a very strong type of thing to be able to solve the carbon problem that I had discussed here. And the carbon problem is really this whole idea of the fact that we focus too much on what we call issues and say that those are problems like too little water, too little nutrients, not the right weather patterns, all those types of things. But what we really have in the end is the fact that our soils are starving for carbon. And if we can get more plants growing and manage the growth of plants appropriately, we're going to be able to get more carbon into the soil and get more productivity out of the soil, manage water better, and provide for resiliency to allow plants and crops to continue to grow under climatic uncertainty that we're heading towards.
And what are some of the strategies for success in that and getting that carbon back in the soil?
Well, the strategies for getting that carbon back in the soil are to increase your plant production, which means not necessarily growing fence row to fence row and narrowing your row spacing, but actually getting your plants to produce more. So getting more vegetative growth in your plants. Some of that can be supplemented by doing things like growing cover crops. So you're adding an additional green growing crop, keeping it in a vegetative phase, where it's going to be putting more carbon below ground, as opposed to putting carbon above ground into the grain. So that can be an important component of it, getting more plants that are growing, keeping the soil covered with living plants, making sure that you have a good diverse crop rotation, so you add that diversity to feed a diverse number of different organisms that are in the soil. You have a whole plethora of organisms representing millions of different species in the soil. And what you need to have is that great diversity so that you retain the resiliency of function and can manage diseases and pests and water and nutrients throughout the growing season. So it's very important to be able to have a good crop diversity. When we have a monoculture system, I equate this to the donut diet. And basically what we've done is we've fed our soil donuts. And I use donuts not just because, donuts are something that many people can relate to wanting to eat a bunch of, but donuts, it's important because the donuts are basically a lot of what our monocultures are. Very high carbon, so very high sugar types of things that isn't very good for the entire system to function. There's not a lot of protein, there's not a lot of other nutrients involved in that. And that's what our monocultures are based on, are these donut type crops rather than based on very diverse crops. So the crop rotation can be important. Again, keeping your soil covered with a living plant can be important. Keeping your soil, reducing the amount of disturbance that you have in your soil, which can come from excessive tillage. Tillage can be a tool to help to manage some pests, but you need to utilize tillage appropriately and utilize the appropriate tools and make your decisions to utilize tillage as sort of a last resort. What are the other things I could do? If I did have cover crops or companion crops, could I manage weeds better that way so I wouldn't have to use tillage as a tool? And then, also be looking at, I think livestock are a very important tool to be involved in this. Having a grazing animal is very important to being able to stimulate more carbon cycling in the system. It stimulates some exudates out of the roots, breaks off root hairs, which feeds more biology. So you get more of the carbon flowing through the biology. And when you do that, you have different biological organisms that are now going to take some of the more labile carbon, the carbon that rapidly turns over, and actually secure that utilizing biological, chemical, and physical methodologies so that it's going to stay in the soil for decades rather than just a year or two.